points go when you start to get this low. So
they apparently go really fast.
When you go below zero, you are unconscious.
Right.
Okay.
And
so I'm still up.
Yep. And just... every you're gonna start. So you're in. Basically, what happens is you're gonna lose one hit point per round until you get to a negative value. That is, if you reach a negative value greater than your constitution score,
okay,
you're done.
Gotcha.
Yeah. So, but during that time you're unconscious and you can't,
right,
you can't do anything until someone comes and actually heals you. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Okay. So everyone is feeling the effects of lacking a good healer in the party at the time.
Yeah.
Yep.
Or even a poor one.
Even
a poor one, exactly.
Even a bad healer is a good healer in this situation. So, okay, so you're down to one.
Alright.
Dwarf is done. Crossbow time. Let's see. This one's real.
Oh, I'm hoping it'd be me.
Ooh, 17. That's a hit.
God damn it.
What did you shoot me in the face?
You were taking.
Thread the
3 points.
I don't know what I started off with.
Three what points. You started off with 10.
So now you got 7.
Okay.
And then crossbow number 2. Coming at Dunstan.
Ah.
Ooh! That's a crit.
Oh, oh, what?
That's a crit.
Uh-oh.
Where are we here? You're taking... what is that? 9? 9.
Okay.
Oh, where are you at?
I'm unconscious.
Ooh!
Oh.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
You just take a bolt and go down.
-1 right now.
Go! Yikes. Okay. So one of the things that can happen, someone can take a full round action to pour a healing potion down Dunstan's throat. Basically, pour it down there.
I'm going to have to do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you, one of you two. And then me.
Yeah.
Except I used mine.
Harlan's got one, right? Yeah,
well, everyone has at least one. Dunstan actually has 2 on his person.
Mm-hmm. But you can't serve it to yourself.
But he can't serve it
to
himself.
Not exactly, no.
Am I taking your healing potion?
I think you'd probably...
That's completely up to
you'd
you.
You'd probably take whatever's convenient available. Or easiest.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, if you know where the one is you're carrying...
Yeah, well,
and
I
you
do.
Get to that fast,
it's slung
so...
slung on my hip. I might as well use it.
Yeah.
And then you can always dig through his and get his when
we need to revive you. Mm. Unconscious is not good.
Man.
Okay. Harlan's up. Harlan does have a healing potion, and Harlan is the closest one there. So why don't you move, if you could move one square closer in. So if taking a 5-foot step is considered a free action, so I can still do the full round.
Sure.
Okay.
You are getting... 5 points back.
Okay.
Does that bring
me up to 4?
Okay.
Okay.
Good.
So you're a bit wobbly.
Oh, yeah.
Where are you at now? Are you at 1?
I'm at 1.
You guys are worse for wear.
Jeez, maybe I need to give mine to Ginger.
I'm at, like, a round and a half ago, we were, like, on top of the world, right? Like, we had this guy flanked on all freaking sides,
yep.
3 guys down.
Well, we're all paying attention to him, the guys with the crossbows were training in.
Yeah. See, that's why I was debating, like, when I was over here, do I jump in and fight here? Or do I take a full round action to reload? Or do I try and take a full round to move as close as I can to these guys? Like, even if I had the pistol loaded, they're still out of range, right? So
right.
I'm going to have to run around and even get close.
So am I close enough to Jinjin to give Jinjin a health potion?
You'd have to be next. Yep. So you're in
Jason
Square.
Jason.
Yep. Yeah.
Because I think that's what I have to do right now. Is
so
Vril,
Vril does healing potion. Jinjin hopefully takes the swing of the
of
hypnotic
the century,
hammer.
Yes.
Yep.
Of
okay.
The century.
Yep. That sounds good. And then Dunstan is
that's
now conscious,
plan.
So you would be eligible to attack, or you could quaff your own potion as well.
So okay. what do I need to do to give him a potion here?
So just, yes, your full round action.
Okay.
Yep, so you're good. You're done.
Okay.
How much does he get back?
Oh, that would be good information. Ooh, 8.
Hey!
That's good.
Nearly max.
That'll bring us up to 9.
Yep.
I'm going to take my round. As soon as I come out of it, I'm going to be like, okay, this is serious. Load the pistol.
Nice.
Rather than quaffing another potion, I'm going to load
like
the pistol.
It. All right.
That's where I'm going.
Okay. Sweet.
What does Dwarf Guy do while we're doing all this crazy shit? What's he... He's still standing in the middle of us, right?
Yep.
He's thumbing his nose at you, farting in your general direction.
yep, so Moot Guy... Crossbow guys have shot... Taking your thing, he was waiting to see what his crossbow buddies were going to be doing. And let's see, there's two targets there. It's just Ginger.
Hopefully, the person with the vacuum is done.
Let's see. So you're technically in this square.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. These are squares. Yeah, but those got moved.
All right. Let's see which one he's going for. All right. Yeah, he's going Ginger.
Did I get a chance to swing, or was it spent?
You were
wafting.
You were quaffing.
Okay.
Yep, you were quaffing. That is a miss.
Quaffing, not coughing.
Yeah. On Jinjin.
I was soul quaffing.
The crossbow soul guys.
Super bon bon.
You see the crossbow guys completely drop their crossbows.
What?
And both. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
They're not getting paid enough to stick around watching the other
guys. Well,
they
might hang a left. And come at us.
Yep.
You know, yeah. They might be on the.
These guys are clearly. So. They've got their.
Or they're.
They're looking at this situation.
Yeah, they're gonna back up their buddy.
We're over a barrel, and there's three fewer guys they got to share the loot with. So my guess
That's
is.
True.
Are you serious?
What is that?
All right. Okay. Harlan's up.
Like, use the vacuum and get it done.
Let's see. So Harlan is gonna come around.
It's like a freaking oven in here.
One.
I've never seen them do that.
Usually we're around the corner.
Just leave it. I don't. There's no way this. I don't think this mic's gonna like pick that up.
There we go.
If it does, it's minimal. All
right, Harlan's swinging a dwarfy.
I'd much rather be older.
Plus.
Maybe something here.
Enough.
I just don't know.
Sweeping up out there.
She should have at least two.
Nothing.
Maybe.
Maybe he's eating popcorn before he's
from there from strength.
Oh no!
Nope.
Nothing.
Harlan is just coming up empty here. Vril.
What am I doing here? Going after
it's on you, buddy.
Here?
Yep.
Nope.
Nothing.
Try 5.
Again. Where's that bottle opener? I gotta get the sauce.
I thought we already gave you a healing potion.
Yeah, well, you know, coming back from the dead.
You're going
to
try 2?
Oh, yeah, I get to try 2.
Powerful thirst.
No.
No. All right.
That was really bad.
A 4 and a 3 is basically what you ended up on that one. So you're...
Actually, you would have had to move up anyway.
You went from
right
up the gut hero to...
I had to try to get them out of the guy's
zero,
ribcage.
Buddy. Yep.
Yeah.
All right.
All right. Come on, Jinjin.
Let's go, Jinjin. Hammer of God.
Oh,
God.
Jesus.
Hammer
Christ.
Of 6.
Oh. All right, Dunstan, let's see some blasting.
Am I loaded now?
You're loaded.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. Let's see.
He's been waiting to get loaded all day.
Well, these guys are.
Okay. I would suggest.
Point blank.
Yeah, you gotta
that guy's gonna get gone, I hope.
Yeah, you gotta do it.
What's my situation on the two hit with this guy? Who is he fighting at the moment? Vril?
So he's kind of in the mix, but he's been hacking at... Well, he's been hacking at Jinjin for most of this whole melee.
So you're going this way.
Am I flanking or not flanking?
You would need to be completely diagonal from another party, which you are not.
Oh, I see. I see. Okay.
Sort of face on.
Yeah. So whether or not I'm flanking depends on my relationship to the enemy.
You'd
and
have to be
character.
Here.
Yep. Yep. There would need to be you would need to be in that square.
Because I would be
or someone
opposite.
Would need to be in.
Or
that
I'd have
square.
To move over here.
Or I've got to find a way to maneuver there.
Correct. Your movement speed is 6.
I could move
or 30 feet. Right.
I could move through. Can I move through Harlan Square
with an acrobatics
check?
This is you.
And put myself in a position there?
You can move
there?
Here. Yep. You can do that.
All right.
So that's... Though you are moving... Let's see. Is that an AOO because you're moving here? Yeah, let's have you do an acrobatics check.
All right. Come on now. Come on now! 4 plus 9.
That makes you 13?
Yeah.
You got it. Because it's friendly, so it would just be DC 10 on those.
Okay.
Yep. Nice. All right.
Now, all right.
Flanking.
I'm going to fire.
Okay.
I'm going to fire. Flanking plus dirty fighting.
Plus 2 to hit, plus your dirty fighting. Yep.
Come on, man. Let's do this.
Write this thing down.
16.
Yes.
It's a hit.
Okay, now I get my plus 4 on top of my D10. Because it's a pistola.
Yeah, baby.
Come on now.
Bring it.
Four.
And four.
Eight.
All
right. Eight total.
Whew. Good hit. It's
like a Gatling gun. It's a Gatling pistol.
I need to get about 5 more pistols is what I need.
No. All
right. Moops.
They cost
one,
a fortune.
2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh. Dunstan, they're creeping up behind.
Dunstan, you're
getting
creeped
on. No, I know.
You're gonna flank, though.
You're getting creeped on. Let's see.
Roll a hit.
Is the 14 gonna hit?
Oh.
Oh, it's a question.
Probably is. Well, my AC is 14.
What happens in a tie? I think that's a hit. No, you have to get above your armor class, so that's... Nope, you're good.
Oh,
no, that's nice.
Thank God.
It's a greater than, not a greater than equal.
I'm not in a position to really take a whole bunch
Why
of hits.
Why did this all of a sudden turn into a math class?
Okay, and then...
Because sequel, that's what I do.
1, 2, 3, 4,
because sequel.
What is with that dwarf that he didn't go down? I mean, he's...
12.
Some serious hit points.
Man. And by the way, these people are really ticked at you, man.
I need to drive him into the ground.
Okay, Moops and then Dwarf. Dwarf is coming at
KD.
The 17. Ooh.
Who's the Dwarf swinging at right now?
Dwarf swinging at Harlan. 1d8 plus 3. Okay. Harlan takes a bit of a licking, but she's all right.
What kind of world do we live in where he's willing to turn his back on the island troll?
Well, obviously,
this
safe.
Aristocratic woman who wears
a safe call on his part.
These lovely white gloves. Yep. Okay. All right. Moops are done. Harlan is up.
Holy Hannah.
Take some revenge here.
Come on.
No.
Epic fail.
Man,
with a 1.
Oh. All right.
Just throw that sword in the water.
Come on, Brill. We need hits. We need hits.
10 is not enough.
11.
11 is not. Well, so it technically was 9
and
10. So those are not enough. Jinjin. Come on, buddy.
Come on.
Let's go, Hammer.
If he hits.
If I hit.
And you're going after the dwarf, I'm assuming, right?
18 hit?
18's a hit.
Nice.
Yes.
All right, tonight's
going to crush this guy's skull.
I think that's
a
10. Double check if it's a 10 or a 12. I think it's a D10.
His sheet, we don't know if he's a D10.
Okay.
I think you're 2D6, aren't you?
No. Oh, it is. It's a D12. Even better.
Woo!
Plus 7.
D12 plus 7. Holy
my
balls.
God.
That's what I'm saying.
Come on.
Just
roll big. Come on.
3D10.
This is like
giant
ball.
Huge. Driving the nail.
A super nasty swing, but he is still.
You gotta be kidding me.
Standing. You just
I needed a better
bashed
roll.
Yeah, you needed a better roll than that, but
you just bashed.
At least I hit. I'm just glad to hit.
He's
like
an indestructible lawn gnome.
Okay, so that
Travel
with red eyes.
Indeed.
You know.
My turn.
Dunstan's up.
Son of a bitch.
And now,
like,
are you gonna reload or are you going
no,
to
No, I can't reload. I gotta go to the sword now.
Okay.
I'm in a desperate straits at this point.
Yep. If you care for a suggestion, I would suggest going to the dwarf. But it is up to you.
Yeah.
How close is the dwarf?
The dwarf, so going to the dwarf, you're going to get flanking.
Yeah.
That's true.
Right.
And if you're able to kill the dwarf, you will no longer be. No, you are not flanked, but you're close. Either. You are not
if
flanked.
If either one of these make a step, you're going to be flanked.
Yeah. All right.
What you've done is put yourself in a position to kill and become a hero.
Well, yeah.
With a flourish of the rapier.
What seems to be the theme, this battle, that I keep finishing people off. Let's do that. I'll draw the rapier and see if I can get an attack in at the end of my
round. Yep, you got it. Right. Yeah, so you draw. That's a free action. So.
Okay.
You did hit the barrier there with the wire, so I don't know if you want to
mulligan that one. Yeah,
I got a lot of them. I want to mulligan.
Yeah.
So you're a plus two, right? So,
yep.
All right.
Plus 30 fighting or flanking. That brings you up to what, a 7?
Well, I don't know. What is dirty fighting again? Or no, flanking is 2.
Flanking is plus 2, yep.
Okay. So, 5, 6, 7.
Not enough.
No.
Not enough, gang. All right, Moops.
Wow. God damn it.
All right, Dwarfy.
We suck at this.
I feel like we don't suck at this. I feel like...
You got a lot of Moops you're dealing with here.
We're getting a lot of experience points.
We're getting some really, really bad rolls.
You're getting some really bad rolls. Yeah. Okay, we are swinging at Dunstan.
Please, come on, man.
That's an 18.
Oh, shit.
That's a hit.
No. You need to roll with my die.
Yeah, I know. I need to start. I need to swap with you guys.
I would be more than happy.
The crossbows, however, are not what they're using to attack. Those guys drop both of those crossbows on the dock there. So they are coming at you to really sap things. So you're taking 5 non-lethal.
5 non-lethal, what does that equate to even?
What does that happen? So you are, and you're down to 1 hit point, right?
No, I got four hit points, but I've already taken 2 points of non-lethal previously. Okay. So I don't know how that factors in.
I think Dunson's feeling a little.
Keep it running total. You don't know if your current voice is not really unusual. Your current voice. You're staggered. Okay, so what is your current hit points?
4.
And how many non-lethal points of damage, including this, have you taken? You've taken 6?
Team Tom.
No, how many did you say? How many did you say? Non-lethal.
6 non-lethal.
And I already had 2, so 8 non-lethal.
Ooh, okay, so you are staggered currently. You're staggered. You see me already. Okay, so...
Beat up good here.
I think there's way too much loving going on for the DM at this moment.
The DM loves back.
Now we're really in for it.
We can't allow Tom to look at this anymore.
Oh, God.
It's negative.
We're done here. It's going to his head.
His visibility.
Yeah, I think...
Okay. Objectively...
I think I club Tom.
We're metagaming here, folks. The DM gets clubbed, all right?
No hearts from me.
This is how we LARP.
Okay, yeah.
Let us show you how we LARP.
The way we LARP.
Let me count the ways.
How do I LARP thee?
Okay, all right. So you are currently staggered right now, so you are... I'm trying to figure out exactly what exactly that means. You are staggered.
Staggered may
take a single move action or a standard action each round, but not both. A staggered creature can still take free, swift, and immediate. A creature with non-lethal damage equally to its hit points gains the staggered condition. So you cannot... You can either attack or move. You can't do both.
Okay.
So this sap has kind of beaten the crap out of you. Okay. All right. Moops are...
Oh, man.
Moops are done.
Harlan, do some damage, please.
Harlan, here we go. Dope.
Whoa.
Nice catch.
Thanks.
Roll my dice here.
Reset.
Harlan,
you're worse than
that's
Riddle.
Another one.
Look at.
All right.
Yeah. Riddle's 5% chance of a 5% chance.
Riddle's back after the little dwarf
Damn.
Guy.
Freaking.
No! Epic one.
Two ones.
No, that was a zero.
No, that was a zero, yeah.
20.
Oh! Finally!
Oh, the roller coaster. So, so you should find out what your what the crit. You're with a punching dagger, right?
Yep.
So,
yep.
Punching dagger.
Right here, crit times 3.
Oh, nice.
So you're going to do 6 points of damage. And who did you...
This...
Dwarf.
Dwarf dude.
Actually, no, I'm sorry. An X3 on the crit is you roll that three times. It's not the. It's not multiplied once. It's three rolls. Three
rolls plus...
So 4 was 1. That's,
2,
yep.
3.
Oh. You need to get a 4. Dice tower.
Oh, nice.
So what is that? 8 points of damage. Yeah, dice tower would be a good idea.
Yeah, we'll get
hooked up. Okay. So you did 8 points of damage to Dwarfy.
Little Dwarfy.
Oh, the Dwarfy is no more.
Yes.
Nice. Got out and
finally
sliced his kidney open.
Now that's another one. Actually, that's 2 guys that I killed.
Yeah, at least.
Woo.
Yeah. Go, mm-hmm. Oh, God. You guys needed that one big time. All right,
holy hell.
Jinjin and Dunstan are still on the go. So, Jinjin, you are going to need to do a little movement, and you're going to be going through some difficult terrain because this is you're kind of in the water coming up on shore. But what you can do...
High knees.
...is, yeah, high knees. You can David Hasselhoff up the beach here and get... So you're doing... This is going to take twice your movement to get here.
Okay.
And your movement is what?
20.
20. So, okay, so you're down from... This took 10, 15, and this is still encumbered. So you can get to this square.
Okay, well,
here.
I can at least get
which is what
to
you
where
should
I can
be
attack.
Doing. Yeah, which is what you should be doing. All right, Hammer of God, buddy.
Hammer.
Let's see it.
Hammer time.
Yeah, let's see it.
Let's do it. 8 and 5 is 13.
That's the magic number.
That's what we like.
All right.
13. Let's do some big damage. Or
drop it.
9 plus 7. 16.
That thing is smush. You just cracked his skull with the double hammer.
Right on.
All right, that's done.
That's what we like.
So this guy is done.
Nice.
And this dude, right as you bring the hammer into his face, this guy here just drops to his knees and he's just freaking out. He says, stop, please, stop. I surrender.
Oh, I've seen this happen in Skyrim before. I know what happens next. You turn your back
and
you're up.
Please, don't hurt me.
Is it my turn?
It's your turn.
By chance?
Yep, you definitely have... You have the ability to do whatever you'd like to this guy. Mm-hmm. Perhaps Dunstan's character will come into play here. Are you gonna let him go, or are you gonna slice him a new...
No, I'm not gonna let him go. But I don't think I'm gonna kill him either. I'm just gonna... I'm going to punch him in the face as hard as I can with the hilt of my sword.
Bam! All right, wow. Let's do some non-lethal here.
Hilt punch.
Well, you should be rolling. Why am I
roll the hilt punch?
Yeah.
Depends. Did you hit?
What would that?
Yeah. What would that be? So this guy is. You have a free attack on this guy.
Okay.
Oh, that should hit. 15 plus whatever.
You got it.
So I don't know what that does for damage.
How do you 1d4? So you're just doing it. So you're just a. You're kind of. It's like a natural weapon, like a club.
Yeah, I mean, it would be like the equivalent of brass knuckles because it's a rapier.
It's going to hurt.
They're 1 to 3.
Right now he's got a broken nose. Now you're going to find out if you're going to split his head open.
2 plus, I don't know. I don't think there's anything. Any bonus?
Strength.
You give this guy, you just cry. You see a couple of teeth fall
out. Yeah, it would be, well, I got a +1, right, on strength. Would that apply to this?
Yeah, and this will be non-lethal.
Okay, so 3 non-lethal.
Yep, so you knock out this guy's teeth and break his nose.
Nice. That's good enough. I didn't need to kill him, but he needed to be punished.
But
he's the guy. He's the guy that whacked me over the head that last
round. Oh yeah,
this is how you make an example
you're
of
just
someone
returning the favor.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Now I might return the favor too.
All right. Well, listen, you guys have mopped. So you know you do notice throughout this whole
mopped
as you kind of come to and like the. The blood rage starts to fade away. no one has really bothered you people. Like, clearly these people are no strangers to, like, brawls in this part
everyone
of town.
Else is just
like, everyone's just kind of mind. I mean, no one's really coming close, but everyone's just kind of, oh, nothing going on over there. I don't really know. So you kind of still have, a few things left to do around here, right?
Like pull up this chain.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know about
and
you guys.
You still
I'm really thinking about going to pick up the crossbows. So
you got a moot pirate here who is kind of just like you kind of knock the senses out of him, but he also is not tied up. He's not restrained by any way, so this guy could get up and move around. He might stab you in the neck. Who knows?
I will put him under control.
All right.
Okay. I'm just gonna, you know, punch him in the face and then sword to the throat, and it's basically gonna be don't move.
Don't move. You
okay,
got
and I will take responsibility for dispatching him if he does anything funny.
Nice. Nice.
I have
okay.
a bunch of silk rope if we want to tie him up.
At some
yeah,
point,
I've got
that
regular
may be a good idea,
too.
So. I would say, yes, good idea, though, to gather up those weapons.
At this point, actually, at least disarm him.
Actually, I have thumb screws as well.
Perfect. What vigilante lawyer would there be without thumb screws? Yeah. Oh, God.
Just one more turn. Oh,
yeah.
I think that's a choice on my part to have picked up some thumb screws.
I mean, it would be, yes, we could restrain the guy with rope and all that stuff, but at this point, I don't even know if that's worth doing, is it?
Just take his stuff.
We still need to decide that. This guy may not be worth our rope.
No.
So,
yep. I think we take his stuff and throw it in the sea.
Or take his stuff and throw him in the sea.
There's that too.
Well, there is chain on the end of this dock. We can.
Yeah.
I think we should have him hoist the rest of it out of the water.
Well, he can certainly help. But
he's pretty mangled. I don't know how useful this guy is. I mean, you guys all had to do 3 strength checks to move this thing about 20 feet.
What else is he carrying on his person, though?
He's got very little. He's got this sap thing that he's been. A couple of his buddies have been
slapping us around.
Yeah, you've got to slap you guys around with. There are 2 crossbows though, that are.
Yeah, we should probably
get
those.
We need to collect the crossbows. That's for sure.
Okay,
I'll stay there with the moop. You know,
keep him covered.
One foot on his chest and the sword at his throat. And if I can quaff a potion at the same time I do that without risking anything, I will.
And how fast can Jinjin and Brill move to go collect those. Do
20.
We need both of us to go collect them, or do you just have Jinjin go get them?
Yeah, you're
I think
so
one of us could probably just go.
We're not in turns right now, simply
so.
Because you have no. There's no enemies. There's no immediate threats around. So we are not in.
I'll go
right
and grab them.
Okay.
So.
Okay.
That one.
Gathering up the weapons.
And jump.
No. Okay, so yeah, go ahead and add a couple crossbows to your inventory.
And then come back.
You got the inventory?
Now, you do notice that there's no ammunition.
Which is why they dropped
which
them.
Which is probably why they dropped them, yeah.
Oh, okay.
But finding crossbow bolts in Freeport is trivial.
Probably.
Yeah.
Probably not too hard to do.
Not a problem.
Okay, so we gathered up some crossbows. Some of these guys had swords, didn't they?
Yep, there's a couple like short swords. There's really nothing fancy about them.
Yeah, but I can take the time and collect. I'll collect
the
dwarf. Rest of the
did he have a sword or a battle axe?
So the dwarf has a battle axe and a couple throwing hand axes that are would count as ranged weapons.
Oh, okay. So
I
we'll
sort of get the feeling
stuff.
Like the dwarf was the only one playing for keeps here. Why were they? I mean, they were all coming at us with saps and stuff like that, and he was like full battle axe.
How many of the throwing axes were there?
2.
I think we've Let's rummage through the dwarf and see if he's got anything else interesting that might give us information on who he is,
other,
where
sorry,
he's from.
The other folks had short
if he's got
sort of
notes or anything like
search
that.
This guy?
Yeah, you see two
short
swords.
Nothing.
Yeah, okay. throwing axes, a battle axe, and then 2 crossbows.
2 crossbows. 1 battle axe or 2?
One
battle axe.
1 battle axe, 2
throwing axes,
axes,
throwing axes,
and 2 short swords.
2 short swords.
And 7,000 gold.
Oh, yes.
I'm pretty sure I heard that.
And a boat.
So, yeah, there's really no, I mean, oddly enough, there's almost, like, there's nothing on these people. Like, there's no identifying marks. There's
no
very
tattoos.
Wealth,
no
tattoos. No, these are just, it's kind of a strange mix. I mean, most of the people around here are, you know, certainly, they're not threatening. They're not in great shape. They're kind of poor and downtrodden and filthy. Mm-hmm. And...
But aside from the fact that now most of them are dead, what's their attire like? Was it as threadbare as everyone
pretty,
else?
Yep, yeah, there's really nothing striking or
no medallions.
Certainly
no,
don't.
No marks, no tattoos, really nearly nothing to, nothing
that would connect them with the guy, the couple that were watching us as we were leaving?
Or nope. Were any of them all the right. ones who were watching us?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah,
they weren't.
I mean, I guess what we would want to try and figure out is, were they specifically sent to get us?
Or
we were targets of opportunity?
Targets
there may be no way to tell. But the fact that they were, you know, I don't know, it's odd, don't you think?
It's pretty.
That some of them were, like, whacking us with saps and stuff, like.
Yeah, but these guys started with crossbows. That was intentional.
Well, yeah, it was, but, I mean, isn't it, it seems strange to me that it would be a mix of lethal and non-lethal attacks.
Running around you, whacking you with a switch.
I don't know, maybe that's just what they do.
Yeah.
Start whacking some adventurers around a little bit.
Yeah.
There's someone I don't know. I'm going to go hit him.
Logistic question. Can you gain back any of your hit points or health?
You can through rest. Okay. You can through extended rest.
I'm the only one that'll... I'll regain 1 hour up to 5.
Oh, okay.
But otherwise, yeah, it's rest.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
All right. So, what do you guys want to do?
Oh, I suppose we should go yank my chain.
Yeah, I would say.
You guys want to go start whacking at the end of the pier there, or what?
I'm going to interrogate this guy. I'll interrogate this guy and try and determine whether or not we were targets of opportunity or someone specifically sent them. So, I would be looking to intimidate him and get him to spill his guts.
Okay, so, I want you to run a intimidation check.
That may suck for me.
Well, I can help.
3.
Well, plus 3.
That's not too bad.
Well, what you might want to do is actually have Jin do the intimidation check. If you're going to have someone... Aren't you a plus 7? I thought you had some gnarly...
It's pretty high.
Plus 5.
You're plus 5. You probably, plus 5. Yeah, you probably
have 11 or something.
Again,
you are a non-threatening vigilante lawyer.
Plus 3.
You got a
yeah.
plus 3. Yours is the same as mine. It's not
yep.
bad.
Okay, it's not bad.
But yeah, we can have Jin do it. If I'm holding him here, I mean, if Jin threatens to tear his arms off.
Memory. I think I jogged too hard.
All right. 18.
13?
13.
This guy just kind of gives you like a bloody, toothy grin. He says, I'm not telling you guys.
You've got thumb screws, right?
I've got thumb screws.
Yeah.
Are we going to get into some torture in the middle of the street here?
No, I don't think so.
Well, that's
I
probably
really
not good.
So.
Yeah.
You don't have a problem with that.
He just kind of gives you this toothy, bloody, just like... I didn't really say anything.
But see, I don't really like the sass, so I think I'm going to follow up the Dunstan maneuver with a little whack of the buckler to this guy.
Ooh. All right, roll it.
Punk.
I mean, you're 16. You're going to hit him. There's really no mistake. Yeah. So why don't you roll 16. A 4? Yeah, why don't you D4 to Dizzle?
Just a little nudge.
2, and that is, I mean, not only... Ooh! He's knocked out.
You
knocked the crap out of him. So this guy is just sitting here unconscious.
I didn't like the attitude.
Yeah. Yeah.
Too much sass.
I like it.
Well, I want to grab whatever's by like this scruff or whatever tunic he's wearing.
You're gonna pick
okay.
him up.
I'm just gonna grab him, drag him towards the dock, towards the chain.
Okay.
So he's close by.
As he
you
wakes
do that,
up,
and why don't you? Yeah. There. So why don't you go ahead and move your dude on the.
So I'm going to go to the chain since that's what we're here for. I'm going to drag this guy with me.
Do you want him on your end? Do you want him on the end? Where do you want him?
Oh, just behind. I'll just let him go when I get to the chain.
Doing the Fred Flintstone kind of thing. Gotcha.
Was I able to drink a healing potion? I should probably.
If you'd like to, yep.
Yeah, that's.
Yep.
I'm going to do that now. If he's taken over.
It's probably a good idea for you guys to heal up. Unless you want to somehow like spend the night around here. And frankly,
you would probably
be facing some kind of. Diplomacy, bluff, intimidation checks to like
okay.
find
Stick
any kind
around.
Of hospitable stuff. Okay. But it's totally doable if you want to do that.
No, I'm just interested in
what's
healing potion.
Right now?
Okay.
4. You well,
know.
4 plus minus 8 subdual damage.
Yeah, you need one.
And my maximum, I think, is...
Yeah, your subdual is going to go away. That's fine. That's the instant.
My maximum is 13.
Well, you've used my health potion, so you should have two on you.
Yeah, so I'll take one of those.
D8 plus one? Is that what it is?
Yep.
You roll or...
You go ahead and roll. Yep, go ahead and roll.
Give me five more. Okay. Makes me up to 9, so...
No, I thought it was 7, but that's all right. That's still better.
Okay, cool.
I'm going to grab this chain and see if I can start working it.
Strength check. You were able to move it a little bit before.
16.
Nice. You get a nice big 5-foot chunk of chain starts
Kinjin's
moving out.
Kinjin's not happy with his performance.
I'll have to get out there and help him.
Yep, okay. Strength check.
Move out there first.
Yep.
7. Not so good.
Nah, you really don't seem to add anything to it.
I'll try.
All right.
I'll try. See if I got any.
Really, you're worthless.
Any gas left in the tank
right.
at this point? Oh.
16.
Plus you got it. Yep. Another 5 feet comes up. It's coming closer to the surface again. Harlan's gonna give it a shot. Yep.
Come on.
13.
Yep. Starts coming up. She's got a leap. Bam. Starts. Finally, this kind of like weird, like white chalky tablet that is wrapped in this chain, like just breaks the surface of this like murky, kind of disgusting dark water.
The Ten Commandments.
Yes. And bless you, my child. So it's this kind of like, it kind of comes to the surface and the water kind of washes off it, and you see it's almost got some strange markings on it that you don't really recognize. You also can't particularly make out if it's a particular design or if it's just the wear of the sea has kind of etched random scratchings and whatnot.
No.
It's this big tablet, and it's kind of sitting at the end of the chain here, so you do need to kind of keep pulling it up.
Yeah, we're going to try to get it out to the dock.
Okay.
So we can at least look at it.
Okay, another strength check.
Not as much.
Not so much. Okay, you're pulling, you're pulling.
It's 10.
10.
So heavy.
No, now you're lifting my weight.
You got a 10 on that?
10, yeah.
Okay. All right, so you bring it to the surface here, and Dunstan, as you kind of start hauling it up on the dock, as your hands kind of brush the surface of it, and you can just feel it has like almost like a chalky consistency to it.
Salt-like.
And you can feel like a dusty residue on your hand, but there's nothing left behind, but it just feels...
Gritty.
She feels kind of gritty. Yep. Yep, exactly.
Does it need to get washed off?
I don't know.
So I assume you pull it up onto the... Yeah,
we can use this guy and wipe it off.
Yeah.
I don't know, from you tearing his shirt off.
Okay. Yeah, let's pull it up. Does here. Anyone have any detect magic, perhaps?
No.
Hint, do you have detect magic?
No.
Oh, okay, so I have...
Where would you see that?
Harlan has detect magic at will, so this is a 0 level cantrip. Let's see. Saving throw none, caster level 1 versus SR. So Harlan comes over and she says, "Gentlemen, there's the reek of black magic is on this tablet. I don't know what this is, but it doesn't sound. This is not safe. This object is not safe. Whatever led us here did so perhaps not with our best interest at heart.
We just spent all this time fighting people. We are not gonna put it back in the water.
It looks like a weird stone tablet wrapped in chain. Are there any inscriptions on it?
You said there were some markings.
There's just some like, yeah, there's some just like weird kind of markings on it that look like they could be by design, they could be just random scratchings. You just can't really tell at this point what, if any, language that it is.
So she's determined that it is an object of magic, right?
Yes, like black magic. Like there's this kind of like reek of evil.
Does that provide me any advantages whatsoever in use magic device, which is a skill I have? Can I look at something like that and determine if it has a purpose that's obvious or not? Or not?
Yeah.
No, you in this for sometimes you would be able to handle like you could use like if you found wands and that sort of thing you'd be able to use them. But in this case, use magic device isn't going to.
It's gonna help
like that.
It's a little bit like that, oddly enough.
Perfect.
Get it out there.
All right.
I don't think that I have any skill that's going to
lend
anything to reading.
Whatever we do, we got to get it the hell off this dock into someplace secure where we can have a conversation about it.
Can we unwrap it from the chain and leave the chain, though?
I don't know.
Is the chain, is it something that we can remove the chain from?
Say that again?
Can we remove the chain from this tablet and just take the tablet?
Yep,
or do we have to take
you absolutely you can. There was
maybe he wants the chain.
You can strap it to this guy's ankle.
Nice weapon.
And actually, I wonder if the chain would make a nice weapon.
It probably would, but I have
a new necklace. Heavy. A new necklace.
Depends how big the chain is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Is there an encumberedness to carrying something like this tablet?
I'm sorry. So also. On the inscription in the little cylinder that held the chain in place, there's a little inscription written in the metal there, and it says, "A devil's eyes have shared my sight of a hiding place found only at night. Break this charm to call it forth, but be wary for a devil's fangs, it also claims."
Okay.
I don't know what that means, but it doesn't sound good.
No, it doesn't sound good at all.
Don't break the tablet?
It sounds like to discover what secret the tablet holds.
Break this charm to call it forth, but be wary for a devil's fangs it also
so
claims.
So breaking the charm calls forth some kind of a doorway.
Agreed.
It sounds like the breaking needs to happen at night, or the doorway opens at night,
something
like that.
Or both.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure that I don't want to be doing that or to be around.
Not particularly.
But
right
I'm wondering. But I'm kind of wondering whether or not our pal Brunner might be willing to part with some coin in exchange for it. Despite
maybe.
The fact that we have absolutely no clue what he's cooking up in the upper room.
Well, we also got to decide too. You know.
But is it something that we can? We gotta ask somebody about it, right?
Who hid this? Iron Jack? Right?
Well, you did. That's
we're
led here. Yeah, you
that's
led
the path we're following.
Yep.
We're following Iron Jack. If Jack led us to this, what's on the other side, right? Like, how far do we follow this thread?
Aren't Jack's bones?
Personally, I think what we need to do is secure the thing. Put it someplace for safekeeping for the moment. Get ourselves healed up, re-equip, and then have a discussion about what we want to do next.
Yeah, well, yeah,
because
we can't do anything with it right now, not in our condition.
Yeah, what we need to do is just get it out of sight, because we're standing at the end of the dock here with this strange thing and a bunch of dead bodies.
And Harley can't read anything on it? She doesn't know what the rules are?
Nope, just that it's dark magic. There's evil that's emanating off this thing.
Mm-hmm.
Man, a lot of black spot dances going on lately.
Mm-hmm. So, I guess I would look to Harlan and ask her if is there some place safe we can take this for now, and basically lay low.
Does Harlan know anywhere around?
Sure.
Here?
Yeah. So,
she's just telling us it's bad.
There's actually a couple so you're in this little shanty town area and. You know, to get in, to kind of dip into one of these little kind of shelters inconspicuously probably wouldn't be that big of a deal. I mean, you just had this huge brawl with, basically had this massive rock'em sock'em robots fest with about six dudes. Nobody seemed to notice. So, you could definitely take it somewhere kind of inconspicuous for inspection.
Yeah, I think that's
night,
what we
rest up.
That's what we want to do. We'll haul it someplace where we can lay low, we can get healed up, and then we can, once we're on the mend, we can have a rational discussion about what the hell do we do next.
What have we done?
Right now it's like, yeah, we're in the middle of all this chaos and bleeding and
Okay.
Sitting on a rickety.
Do you want to try to like find an unoccupied little shanty here? Perhaps this little kind of, you know, this is like the kind of like that local free house pub house that people were in and out of.
Hostel.
I would think if we can find some place that even if it's a rundown shack that's uninhabited, that we can defend and have a solitary kind of a thing going on, that would be better.
Okay. Well,
I don't know.
All of them. Yeah.
You think?
I agree with that.
All right, because we don't know what this is. We don't know who else is going to come after it.
But Dunstan's going to use it as a pillow.
All right, so after searching around for a little bit, you do find that this area is particularly kind of removed from... there's not a lot of traffic coming here. It's kind of off to the side. So any one of these buildings would meet your needs for being off the path. So I guess it's up to you guys on which one of these you want to put in.
I don't know. Let's drag it into this one.
Yeah, it's kind of what I was thinking.
You know, and we should be able to just kind of defend that space.
Yep.
Put it in the back room or whatever, and then all kind of find a spot to lay ourselves out and get some rest and food and healing and check the equipment and figure out what to do next.
Cool. All right, why don't you put your dudes where you want them in there and.
Are we gonna leave a dead dude? Disabled dude is on the dock.
Yeah. There is an unconscious.
I think we can leave the unconscious guy over on the pier. Do you want to take him with us, or do we want
to? I don't want to take him, but I think it'd be funny to strap that chain to his ankle.
Why not?
We have the key.
Should we tie him up at the end of the pier and leave him there?
Yeah, I'm thinking so. Because if we need to go ask him questions, at least we know where he is.
With a sickle at the end of the pier.
And we can always throw him in the drink if he doesn't cooperate.
Well, he's already on the end of the pier anyway. We can loop the chain around his ankle and then relock it or something like that.
We're all in there.
If he wants to sit there and scream for passersby to help him all day long, he can do that. That
should get him a long ways over here.
Uh-huh.
All right. You find yourself inside here.
All right. Let's
window situation. The door. Anything?
There's some small windows. This is definitely not the lap of luxury. But
there are a couple little holes
in walls that pass for windows.
I just want to make sure if there's a way to block him or hang something over him.
Right, right. Well, you're pretty far removed. I mean, you're kind of at the far edge of this little and you're on the outskirts of town anyway. So
put it somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Is the fireplace serviceable?
Yep.
And is it something we want to light?
No.
It would immediately let somebody know that there's somebody in the building.
That's a good point.
Yeah. I think we just,
Cold camp it.
Put the thing in the back room there.
Near the fireplace.
And we all hang out in the front room there and get some food, get some rest, get some healing. And once we've gotten ourselves squared away, figure out what we're going to do next.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So let's see, what do we got left for potions? I got one healing potion left. Anybody else got something?
I've got nothing.
Okay, who's worse off?
Well,
Harlan's got a couple left.
Potions?
Yep.
Oh, she does?
Yep.
In 5 hours' time, I'll have healed 5 points.
You just want to rest for the night, quaff a couple potions. Yeah. Harlan's got 2 to throw to the cause.
And that'll bring me 14 out of 15, so...
So you're good there. Yep.
I have a 7 out of 10, but I don't know if I regen anything, so...
So if you guys rested overnight, getting 3 hit points back, that's fine.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. If we rest overnight, that would get me up to 12 out of 13, so I'd be almost there.
Yeah.
Do we get to rest overnight, or do we need to sort of take watches and...
Well,
that's probably...
Might not hurt.
Yep. Keep one person up.
Still with the. There's still enough of us where we should be able to get enough rest that we could heal.
Yeah.
But someone keeping one of you guys awake for, a few hours at a time is probably a good idea.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
we'll rotate.
Yeah. We'll rotate watch.
Okay.
Yeah. Seems like a good idea.
Who wants? Who's the least injured?
Well, I've got 7 out of 10.
Harlan's pretty good. She's 5 out of 9.
Want to take the first couple watches.
We'll take the first couple watches.
Yeah. Okay. Sounds good.
And then by morning, I'll be full.
So you pass the night. Uneventful. Nice. So there you are. Morning is rising over this kind of
eventful
edge of Scurvy Town and the docks. It's just kind of this little armpit of Freeport that time seems to have forgotten. And the sun's coming up.
Oh, that's all right.
And you all wake up a little bruised up, but certainly no permanent damage. And here you are with this evil tablet.
Evil.
Okay.
Every villain is lemons.
All right.
Sorry. That was good.
Well, I guess we need to have a discussion about what we do next.
Harlan's the one who figured that it was riddled with black magic. Is there anything else that we can
tease
out of her?
We can try. I mean, now that we're rested and, you know, we have some daylight, let's inspect this thing again. Have her look at it. She was able to tell us that it was magical. She was able to tell us that
while it was wrapped in chains and dirty and wet.
Yeah,
and
that it was bad magic, and that also had the inscription on it. So let's go over the facts again and see
if there's anything new
that comes to light.
Sure. Yeah. So you know, Harlan, you know, just lets you know she just cast a simple spell that she learned called Detect Magic. It's a, you know, she can kind of do that at will, and all it does is just there emanates because kind of aura. There's almost like a glow and kind of sense that almost just paints anything that has magic energy associated with it. And this tablet certainly does. On top of that, there's this sense that this is not good. Like it is, meaning that it is not. This thing is evil, whatever it is. But other than that, we were sent here to learn
about it. Maybe enough just to learn that someone didn't want it around enough that they chose to throw it off the end of the pier.
You've definitely been, I mean, it's almost like, you know, you've followed some clues that have been left behind almost intentionally by the Iron Jack, by Jank and Hammer.
Mm-hmm.
And this figure is pretty mysterious. You know, he was around for a while, and he got all this fame and notoriety, good notoriety, and then he just disappeared, and then he came back again, somehow changed and weird, and no one really seemed to know what happened. And then
he was gone.
And then he was. Then he's been. And he's been gone. And that was.
Can you read us the
years ago? The inscription.
The inscription.
Yeah. The inscription on the little cylinder that held the chain in place says, "A devil's eyes have shared my sight. Of a hiding place found only at night. Break this charm to call it forth, but be wary, for a devil's fangs it also claims."
It's a hiding place found only at night? Is that what it said?
A devil's eyes have shared my sight. Of a hiding place found
hiding only
at night.
Okay. Okay.
But if you break it, it also claims a devil's fang?
Well,
break this charm to call it forth, but be wary, for a devil's fangs it also claims.
The only way that, if there's something hidden there, it's something that Iron Jack hid, or someone else hid that he found.
Mm-hmm.
We get to the hiding place by breaking this thing, but obviously it's guarded by something nasty. So,
good thing we're healthy.
Personally, you know what we should do? Is we should go back to Martin and say, this is what we got, but if you want us to do this, it's going to cost you.
That makes sense.
Right?
Not a bad idea.
I mean,
what we already had to do, right? You know, we happen to go to a part of town where we're following up on this stuff, and we have to dispatch all these people who, for whatever reason, have decided that we're worth fighting.
Yeah, This isn't just to go and explore some old ruins thing or whatever. That's kind of the picture he painted, you know, at the beginning, right?
Yeah,
this is becoming
changed a little.
Much nastier. So I think that's what we should
bloody.
Do.
So do we leave it here or bring it with us?
So we have to hike all the way back across town to find Martin.
I don't think we should. I
think we should find some sort of a courier or something who can send word.
I think we should stay here, and either one of us should go and get him and bring him back, or we should find some other way.
So Harlan steps up. Harlan would be willing to go
She would.
To go back. Yeah, she definitely feels this thing should probably not be
left alone.
Be moved around.
No, I think it, dragging it through town would be bad. Yeah. Leaving it alone would be bad.
She really wants a shower.
Oh my God.
She really wants a shower and a
biscuit. You guys, and moving through town as this group, you know, you see all have seemed kind of conspicuous, and you know, you've caught attention from Stephen the Threadbear, weird hooded Jawa looking guys. Poor old Stephen.
Yeah. And a band of psychos.
We need a sort of a picture of Stephen the Threadbear.
Okay.
So Harlan's gonna hoof it back to Martin, and we're inviting Martin back down here. Yeah.
Well, I guess.
Or at least let him know what's going on.
What we can,
can't be holed up forever, right? No. So what are we asking Harlan to take as a message?
I think what we're saying is, Martin, we found something that you need to see. That would entice him to come. And then once he gets
vague
here,
enough.
Then we're going to negotiate.
He has hired you guys to find some sweet crap.
And he's sitting around going on a couple of days now, probably chewing his nails, wondering if we found anything. Let's drag him down here.
I like
and
your
then,
vague message.
Once he's in the room, then we'll see what we can do to negotiate.
I mean, it really only has been an afternoon. So, I mean, you guys met and you went straight to the Freeport Institute.
Yeah.
Mucked around down there for a couple hours and then came.
Holy crap.
Down here.
Yeah, that's true.
You really only stayed one night.
It's been like 36 hours. It's been a really busy 36 hours.
Yeah. We're efficient.
Yeah, you have been busy.
Damn.
But we also met him and then went through the pub under basement pub crawl and then killed a whole bunch of people and stole the thing out of the water, and now we're holed up in somebody else's house.
Harlan goes, and it's going to take her a while. She actually she'll end up hiring. You do notice that they're all they're kind of like rickshaw things, so there are guys that are kind of carrying big wheel shaped things. So she's gone for a good chunk of the day and comes back with Martin Hammer. It's now sundown, and Martin Hammer has come back.
Yes, that's what he turned out to be, isn't it? He held those bastards off for just long enough.
Yeah, he did.
So Martin Hawks comes back in, and he comes in, and he's just like, first of all, you see him looking around the spot, and he's like, you can clearly see that this is like, he's an upper middle class merchant. He's not used to mucking around. He's just kind of like,
in this smelly room with shiners and cuts. And
he comes and wants to sit down. He has rubs jacked
up.
Kind of drapes his like handkerchief across the seat before he sits down on it. And he's just like, say, gentlemen, this better be good. What is going on?
Well, Dunstan and Jinjin and Harlan and I have come across something curious. We think that it hasn't been seen for a long time.
Curious? What is it?
You should take a look.
So, Jinjin, as you haul this big clay tablet and slam it on the table, a little chunk, a little corner, breaks off from it. And it's like, it's almost like...
Oops.
Yeah, nothing is quite pulsating yet, but you feel on your hand as well this kind of like weird chalky kind of residue, but there's nothing on your hand, but there's nothing visible on your hand at all. All
right,
it's just this kind of chunk,
like a fly after he's landed.
So as you kind of stand on the table there, the whole thing just kind of is now there's this big kind of crack running through it.
Nice job, Jim.
Oh my God.
Well, we wanted you to see something.
Tape it!
So Martin looks down and he says, "Jump! What is this? Is this what this is about?"
Yes.
Of course it is.
We hauled it up from underwater, and it is clearly something vile. And if you want us to pursue this any further, you're going to have to pay up, because if this is going to get pursued as it is now, you're going to do it on your own.
He says, "Well, how did you find this?"
"We followed the breadcrumbs."
What breadcrumbs?
there was the keys, the hall, and then the lube, and all that stuff.
Forgot about the lube.
The oil lube.
Yes.
Ah, armor lube.
Yes. That's basically how Dunstan would explain it, because he's getting impatient now.
Martin says, is this part of the Iron Jack?
Yes.
Is this his legacy?
I don't know, but he has the key that helped us find this thing and pull it out of the water. So he provided us with the clues to get to this, so he obviously knew something about it, and clearly he was trying to hide it because it's bad, bad, bad.
Wrapped in chain, thrown to the bottom of the end of the pier.
Yeah.
But please come and find me later, because here I'm conveniently locking it into this thing so that you can get it some other time.
Yeah, I know. It's really curious that way, isn't it?
What do you think, Martin?
He stops to think. He says, "Well, if this is part of the Iron Jack's legacy, then I think this could fetch a fair price."
Problem.
And you can just see him. He's just already like the hamster wheel spinning, and he's just kind of counting the money that he could get from this thing. And as you're all sitting there chatting, the crack in this clay tablet starts to almost expand.
No!
And it's slowly,
hold the shot!
It's almost like an old Bobby Coyotes, where like they just starts cracking like ice. The
guys,
I'm still short of hit points. God dang it!
Guys, this is bad.
As it cracks and cracks completely in half, sitting on this table, it just. All the pieces fall to the floor, and you see projected directly in a circle right here, as this is the table, projected right here is this weird, like, glowing red and green kind of swirling circle that's in a 10-foot radius here, so it's taking up this entire corner.
Wow.
And this bed and all the stuff that was in there just gets ejected from here, so there's nothing in the circle here. And within a few moments, you see this small form start to appear. And it almost like, you can't really tell if it was always there or not. And it just kind of starts growing and expanding from
evacuate.
The center thing. And
the door.
Jinjin, you feel like you've just completely been like covered in this like dust. It's still, you can't see anything on you. And slowly out of the center of this kind of glowing circle is this weird beetle-looking thing.
Great.
It's almost like a twisted, almost like a cherub, except it has like cockroach body and these super gross wings and like.
Oh, that's not a cherub at all.
No, it's like the anti-cherub.
That's not what I was thinking at all.
Scarab. Yeah. So
scarab, not cherub.
Okay. Yeah, I was gonna say
cherub looks like. It almost looks like this weird bug-looking thing.
That is really unpleasant.
That's
not cool.
That's pretty gross.
And it starts buzzing around the room.
Let's
see if we can get some look-see here.
Nate.
All right, everybody.
Yeah.
So it is kind of a cherub
time.
Kind of a cherub scarab.
All right.
Yeah,
hey,
that's a scarab. Yeah, exactly.
Gross.
And it starts hissing around.
Nice job, Jinjin. We
and
were nice and calm and.
And it says, "Who called me?" And it's got this, like, hissy kind of voice that's super, like, this thing is bad news.
He did.
And you guys are terrified. Who called me?
He's at the pier.
Martin.
Yeah, Martin did.
And it starts kind of buzzing around, but you notice it wants to, like, fly at you, and it just, bam! Like, every time it hits the perimeter of this little circle of light, this weird, twisted light that's outlined on the floor, it rams up against it. Almost like it's like a bug
like a
in glass.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so, and Harlan is looking at it, she's just ashen-faced, and she says, this is a circle. This circle will protect us. This is a beast from one of the nine hells. And, and she knows that it's called a Zebub. And these Zebubs are like these like messengers sent from other planes.
Oh, man.
This one particularly is from one of the chaotic evil hells. This thing is just this is evil through and through. And
I'm not going fishing again.
What Harlan knows about these, and she tells you, is that these are always sent as messengers, and so they're here, they're prisoners until they deliver a message, and that's all she knows.
Oh God!
Wow.
But like you're in this room and there's just this buzzing and it's moving almost like a light, like a huge like pony sized like lightning bug that keeps slapping.
Maybe
up against the wall.
Thing that's hidden is the message itself. the next crumb in the trail, so to speak.
A devil's eyes have shared my sight of a hiding place found only at night. Break this charm to call it forth, but be wary for a devil's fangs, it also claims.
So, let's see. Let's assume, based on Harlan's description, if she's right, we ask it, it's asking who summoned me. Like, it wants to give up its message.
And I love how everyone takes a half step back and points at Jinjing. He did.
Yeah. I actually wanted to point at Martin, to be honest, but...
He did it!
Yeah. I mean, if it... What happens, though, if it gives up its message and it's released from its requirement to deliver this? Like,
so,
does it go away?
Yes.
Or does the circle go away? I know.
What Harlan can tell you about this and what little she knows is that, indeed... These things can be brought forth to deliver messages, and once they deliver these messages, they're no longer held prisoner inside.
They actually
get sent. They return back from where they came, because right now this thing has been stuck inside this tablet for God knows how long, and it's angry. And the rest of you around in the perimeter are starting to feel tugs at your mind, like, and it's almost this like hissing, angry sound that says murder. Murder!
But I don't even speak Parcel Tongue.
Red Rum.
And it is just like you get this overall sense.
So
of just
so we gotta we gotta tell it pretty quickly who summoned it.
Yes.
Who summoned me?
I think Martin summoned.
And it seems to be like hitting this like wall, like keeps going right at you.
Do we? Why
so it's something that we all claim responsibility.
Why don't we say Iron Jack? Does it have to be somebody there? Who summoned me?
Well, I don't know.
Which one of you summoned me?
If we say that it's not someone that's in the room, is it going to give up the message? That's the thing. I think we need to take responsibility
for summoning
it.
Thing.
I mean, right?
I do.
It just says, who will give me my freedom?
Oh, me. Same question, different delivery.
Oh, yes! Alright, yeah, I'll acknowledge.
Okay, so, and he looks at it was you. What will you ask of me?
Oh, God.
What is your favorite?
Can you just ask what message you have for sure?
So it was saying it had, that it was, no, it didn't say that
no,
it had.
That
so
was,
it was
that
bound
was,
in
that
this
was,
tablet.
Right.
And this, it's been sealed there, it's been a prisoner in there, and it's clearly trapped inside
right.
the circle right now. And Harlan knows, and Harlan's telling you that once this thing's curse, once this thing has been commanded to do, it will then be released to return from the plane where it came.
I ask Carlin, how many questions do we get?
she's like, I don't know.
Let's kind of look around. What do we want to...
Ask it who trapped it in there.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a good opener.
How did you get in there?
How did it get trapped? Right.
Who trapped you?
So it responds, it says, it was the Iron Jack who trapped me in here. But I saw the vision. He's trapped me in here with the Vision. And it's just the Vision a couple times.
Not like the Marvel character?
Not like the Marvel character.
Because that would be cool. We could use him.
And it's like
what's
constantly
the vision?
Buzzing and
tell
moving
us
around.
About the Vision.
Yeah.
What Vision?
Oh. The moment you ask, what is the Vision? There's this mental, you get this like mental flash. And it's terrifying. It's super. You just have this complete like sense of like just evil and just dark power. And you see some. You see in your mind's eye. You're basically like there's this flash that's clearly not of your own thinking. And inside your head, you see stone monoliths cast long shadows in the light of the full moon. A man is walking along the edge of the forest north of the city, beyond Drax End. Drax End is where the Institute was.
Right.
The trees are thick and healthy, and this was many years ago, well before the Great Green Fire, and the trees are much closer to the city. Two tracks from Freeport meet to form a wide dirt road that leads north toward the gentle slopes, toward the gentle southern slopes of the distant mountain. The man stops at the intersection and instead heads due south through the forest to a hidden stone structure, the remnants of a small building or platform. Steps lead up to a circular area where a large statue of an aristocrat elf stands. A figure emerges from the shadow cast by the statue, though you could swear it was not there a moment before. It shambles forward, shambling in an unnatural cadence, its limbs bent at odd angles. It bears a polished white skull, which it presents to the man. The man pulls something from a chain around his neck, a key perhaps, with a crescent moon sigil, or perhaps an actual piece of the moon, for it throws a blue light into the dark shadows. Moving towards the statue, the man raises the key, and by the light it emits, a keyhole appears. He inserts the key and opens a doorway, an opening into the very shadow itself, and then he steps inside, bearing the polished skull. Does anyone have a wisdom roll they'd like to make? Please, everyone make a wisdom check.
I'd like to make one.
Yes, please do.
Okay, Vril.
I'd really like to make one.
Got an 11.
13.
So...
I got a straight up.
18.
18.
Can't hit shit, but I'm feeling wise.
1.
Well, that's how appropriate
fitting.
So, yeah, so the what occurs to you, Jinjin, is that the road that was seen in this vision is the road north that leads to the village of Cabbage Crack today, and the stone platform would be somewhere near the north edge of Drac's End. And you also recognize that the echoes of the devil's thoughts intermingled slightly with the vision from long ago, and a name popped into your head when the man approached the statue, which was Lord Bonerack, who, if you recall, the elf headmaster of the Institute had shared the legend of Lord Bonerack.
Which I poo-pooed.
So you get this, yes. So you get the
ridiculous
sense,
I don't remember Lord
slight
Bonerack.
Tinge when that appeared in the vision,
okay.
that the anecdote of Lord Bonerack was the first thing that came to your mind. And that's all you get.
Alright, well, I will definitely share.
So as soon as this vision happens, what you see is, like, you hear this thing hissing, it says, I'm free, and it kind of goes back, and it just starts to kind of, like, it completely disappears, but it neither seems to move nor flash away, it's just simply just vanishes, almost like it was never there, and the circle... The glowing circle of light on the floor just fades away. And the house is totally returned to...
Jinjin's the only one who heard all the stuff?
Jinjin was given this vision.
All right, well, I'm going to share my vision.
Okay.
Wow. All right.
So...
Very good.
The vision has been shared.
This one is...
Ooga, booga, ooga, booga, ooga, booga!
Freaking so, out!
It was... Cabbage Patch? What? Where was it?
Cabbage Crack.
Cabbage crack.
What,
yes.
Do I know anything about that?
No. So you don't specifically know, but as soon as you describe the setting and the name Cabbage Crack and this little kind of stone-ish gate right in Drac's End that Harlan and Martin both recognize, they can kind of point you right where this vision started to lead you.
Mm-hmm. All right. So we gotta go to Cabbage Patch.
So I think that this is probably a good place to stop.
And we've got a key with a crescent on it. Do we have any of those?
No.
You don't yet.
No.
You don't
if we
yet,
did,
but
I know.
You did see...
No spoons either.
So there are no keys with you now, but you did see in the vision this strange shadowy figure hold up a key.
With a crescent on.
With a crescent that seemed to glow in the dark and shed its light because of your dark vision.
I didn't get a key from it. Alright. Okay. I don't want to stay here.
Alright. So Martin offers to take you back to the merchant district and put you up in the inn where you guys had
okay,
all the cafe located. So
I don't care what they were doing. I'm not staying here.
Probably a good idea.
That sounds fine to me. I think we're ready to go back out.
This particular dwelling kind of creeps me out now.
Yeah, we're probably doing
not feeling good about it.
Whoever has to come back home to this place isn't going to like it.
Screwed.
Yeah. All right.
Just leave the smashed tablet for them.
All right,
what happened to
you
the
now
tablet?
Have just completely disintegrated.
Okay, so it's like it was never
cracked
there.
Cracked, destroyed.
Or is it just kind of dust?
Yep. There's just, it's almost like it was never there.
Okay.
Everything's just covered in a fine layer of gypsum. We'll never get all this cleaned up.
They cleaned it for years.
Our luck, it's probably asbestos.
Yes, exactly.
All right. Are you feeling good about this as a stopping
point? I think
point?
This is a perfect place to stop.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to call it for tonight. Thank you all for tuning in. We actually went a whopping 3 hours and 20 minutes, which is the longest session we've had to date. We thank you all very much for tuning in, and we'll see you in a couple of weeks where we're going to do this again. Remember, the next live stream we do will be actually a podcast.
You,
it'll be a podcast for an hour, followed by a couple hours of Pathfinder, okay?
Woo!
So,
thank you.
Until next time, take it easy. See you guys. Bye-bye.